till now to watch it burn.
I said, I'm a believer, I follow after Christ, not man. Because at the end of the day, man can't save
us. Amen. That's true. And that's really ultimately what's going on, is men follow their own hearts. They go astray by a variety of things. I mean, you cannot find a pocket or corner of the world nowadays that is not tainted with corruption. The more I look, the more I search, it's in every industry, including my own, healthcare. I saw a movie recently called Side Effects, which, you know, just another angle of it. I don't want to spoiler alert type of thing here. Won't give away the whole plot, but, you know, and the ability to manipulate stocks by causing certain things to happen so that people will stop buying the one product and buy another. So people are basically chasing after the dollar. That's the main motivation. The Bible says this.
The Bible talks about reason with one another.
Yeah.
You know, let us come together and reason. So, we can have all these, there's a lot of discussions and stuff and hatred and all that, you know, but at the end of the day, you still my sister, you still my brother.
Yeah. I think there's much to be said for the idea of not being afraid to back down from the truth, even though it offends and hurts somebody. The Bible says that faithful are the wounds of a friend, but deceitful are the kisses of an enemy. So many times the truth does hurt, and we should not shy away from presenting that truth, but we should try to do it in as winsome and, you know, congenial a way as possible. I certainly agree there. But that doesn't mean that there's never a time for harsh or scathing words. In fact, Jesus, the apostles, prophets, did so, and they were not sinful in that.
I'm an atheist.
Why have you selected that particular pathway?
It doesn't matter why I've selected that. I don't believe in any religion. I don't even think I'm an atheist.
No,
I think
you are
nothing.
You have imbibed a religious philosophy, and that's the religious philosophy of atheism. Mine is the religious philosophy of Christianity.
Why did you choose that path?
Because God had preordained from of old that I would believe in Him. He has transformed my heart, regenerated my spirit, so that enlightened my mind, that I would believe. It says that He resists the proud and gives grace to the humble. Now, unfortunately, well, I guess fortunately and unfortunately, depending on who you are, a goat or a sheep, that can't happen without the power of God to transform you. Fortunately, because the sheep who are transformed cannot fall from that grace. Unfortunately for the goats, because though they may try and travail to get to that point, will never succeed.
You know, I just thought I'd say one thing or two. It's like, I'm glad I don't have a home to go to. I'm glad I don't have a TV. I'm glad I don't want more than my share of the world's resources. Yes, I don't know if I'm left wing. I do hate America in some ways, but I'm grateful to be here. I don't hate Muslims. I mean, I apologize for that one. They don't scare me. Some of their governments scare me. Some of the murderous ones scare me. Some of the murderous Christians scare me. Some of the governments purporting to be Christian that are murderous scare me. This discussion scares me quite a bit.
Does it? Well, then you scare yourself because you were the only one talking. Unless you're... Don't need to live in fear. Don't live in fear, folks. Perfect love casts out all fear. That's what Christ will provide you. He will give you a peace that passes all understanding because you know that you are one of His.
I was here last night, actually, and there was this one guy. I don't think he wasn't able to answer my question.
Okay.
Why? Okay. So you have your best. You have your beliefs, and you know that grants you your serenity, your peace of mind, and that's good for you.
Not all the time, but continue.
Well, but and my like sense of religion, I may not agree with you in that, but you know that makes me happy. Why is Why is that not good enough for you?
Well, first of all, let me elaborate a little bit. Sometimes my worldview troubles me very much. A lot of times people assume that it's only for psychological reasons that people come to accept their worldviews. Not always. Many times it is the case. But many times my worldview cramps my style, would prohibit me from living comfortably in my sin. The things that my flesh, there's a struggle going on within where I would want to do certain things and that would not be the way to go. And likewise, thinking about multitudes of people going to hell isn't all that comforting of a thought. Instead of, I could just adopt something where all roads lead to heaven. Universalism. So there's not comfort in my view all the time.
Well, what's to say I'm going to hell for whatever I happen to believe in? Exactly what is...
Not what's to say, who's to say, and God says, and he is the authority by which can condemn you, and so therefore it is.
Yeah, but not everyone believes in that authority or accepts that as authority, like me. Like,
does it matter if you believe something?
Well, I don't know...
As far as it being true or not?
We don't know if he is the authority. We don't know if he even exists in the first place, so...
Well, you don't know.
You don't know.
How do you know
sure
what
you
I know?
You don't know why. I'm pretty sure you don't know either.
How do you know what I know?
I don't. That's the thing. But like, you have.
So then don't claim that I don't know.
Well, look. Okay, I'm gonna use that one. But why is like okay? I could be a Satanist for all you know. I could be a Muslim. I could be a Jew.
Yeah, I don't know yet.
Why is that just like not good enough for you? Why do you have to like come here and like attempt to like change what I believe?
Yeah, what's your problem?
Why have you had the conviction enough to step up to the microphone to change my view on how I should be not changing other people's views?
I'm not trying to change your view. I'm just.
So aren't you doing the same thing?
I'm not changing.
Well, you're challenging me. I don't mind. I don't mind. By the way, I actually appreciate it. I like that you have the courage of your convictions. That's
so
good.
I
like the fact that I actually don't like the fact that more people aren't like you, willing to express their views. So I applaud that. Okay, and it's not to be anything you should be shameful for. I don't know if you want him to cut in on you like that, but if you want, then he can go ahead. I thought it was.
This is just a real quick.
Okay, go ahead.
So this old Indian chief is talking to a priest, and the priest says to him, so if you didn't tell me about this heaven and hell stuff, would I go to hell? He says, no, if you don't know, you're completely innocent. And he says, well, why the fuck did you tell me?
Okay, watch your mouth. I think there's a baby there, a little kid over there. That wasn't too considerate. But that falsely assumes that people who are ignorant aren't held accountable for their sins of ignorance. And the Bible says, no, people will be held accountable for all their sins. And also the Bible teaches that we are not ignorant of that God exists and he is the God of Scripture. It's just that we suppress the truth and unrighteousness. So everybody knows that God exists, even the professed atheists, but they have been suppressing it for years, years and years, so much that they believe the lies that they preach to themselves. Okay? So...
What's to say that they're lies? What's to say that...
But yeah, it would logically follow, if that were true, but it's not, that if, you know, people who are ignorant died in their sins automatically went to heaven, then it should be stupid for sending missionaries. I agree with that, if it were true, but anyway, continue.
What's to say that what I do is a sin? What's to say that what you're doing is a sin?
What is morality? What is truth? That's one of the big questions of life.
I guess that's one way of looking at it, I guess. But
what is the essence of saying what is truth? How do we know anything? Can we even talk? Epistemology is what we're now in the realm of. And we do have to all consider that, folks. My voice is starting to crack a little bit.
I just want to know why, if I'm going to live my life being an atheist or a Satanist or a Muslim or a Jew, why can't you just...
Can you put your cards on the table, if you don't mind? What are you?
I'm Jewish by blood, but okay. Agnostic in belief.
Okay, fair enough. Continue what you're saying.
Bordering on atheist, but why can't you just like accept that? Say, well, this guy's doing his own thing. I don't need to interfere. But you're here trying to. You're here.
What am I doing?
Well, you're free.
Come here, so I can give you a hug.
Okay.
And I won't make you try to believe the gospel. You already know it. How long have you been living in America? You said you're a Grace Jewish. You know the gospel. I preach to other people. You don't care, so what do you care that I care?
Right. I just want to make sure you're not, like, attacking other religions. If you're just promoting...
Why? Part of my religion is to attack religions, and for you to attack that perspective, as I already pointed out, is for you to attack mine. It's inevitable. That's life. That's the essence of tolerance.
You're a racist.
Without disagreement, there is no such thing as tolerance. People trumpet that virtue as one of the king things that we should embrace. Be tolerant. But without that disagreement, there is no tolerance.
Well, I guess
I gladly take that title. Thank you. So, like I said, the key thing is when you're discussing these things, do it in a gentle, nice way. Bear people, and I think you've been kind. So, I think we should encourage this. I think it is healthy to have a nice analytical exchange amongst people so that they not only know what they believe, but why they believe what they believe. I mean, do you really want to go to the grave unassured of your convictions? Like,
I
just
go to Denny's.
Denny's? Is it almost time? 11:22. I got to work in the morning. Shoot.
Well,
what am I doing out here?
Let me ask one more question. Well, what is truth? I mean, like, what you think is truth to you is truth, but what I think to myself
why
is truth.
It's
hey, Dave, you're distracting me. You want to say something? Get up there. I'm sorry. I got that buzzard in my ear. Yeah. He's trying to coach me, but it's not helping.
Like, to you, what you believe is truth, but to me, what I believe is truth. We obviously have very different perspectives. What's to say that your version of truth is the absolute truth?
Evidence.
What's to say? I mean, there's lots of different evidences I could pull out, and I'm not switching this thing here. I'm supposed to.
He's got his own perspective.
But ultimately, we have to get down to the presuppositional level. What are worldview entails at the presuppositional foundational level. Like I said, epistemology. That's where the roots are. I don't like to hack at little twigs and limbs of evidentiary claims because you will interpret the evidence different than I will. We can look at the same raw data and come to totally opposite conclusions.
Well, why are you attacking evolution? That's
because it's unscientific, number one.
It's hey, Cashel, can you help me explain the whole evolutionary thing to the...
I actually don't want to, but I actually did have a question. I personally am an agnostic theist, but
So you're more like a deist then?
Yeah, I believe in God, but I don't really follow any particular religion, but I'm not really sure. But basically, what part of Christianity are you? Like, where would you classify yourself? And if you're not part of one that I would know, like, what is the closest one? I'm just curious.
I would say Reformed Baptist, if you want to be as precise as possible.
Okay, cool. Just wanted to know that. Yeah, I was here the other night, and it was interesting. It was an interesting debate.
Cool. And see, that's what I like, is that sort of response there, that even though he disagrees probably with me, and maybe 90% of what I say, he can appreciate a good, you know, sharpening of wits and discussion.
I must say I enjoy that as well. Oh yeah, what is that thing?
I have no idea. This is all his setup. Get on him.
The dead body.
I didn't do it. Do you have pancake mix? I don't know what that means. What does that mean? He told me to say it again. It's hilarious, whatever it is. Anyway, anything else?
No, I believe that's it.
All right. Questions or comments, folks? Step on up.
I have one question.
Go ahead.